Yeah, till the time Meher helps us with the setup, we'll just go through some, you know, a brief understanding of who all are there, what kind of audience we have. So though it's about content, it's very important that we have developers here as well. So how many are developers? Mumbai is full of developers. Do you write content? How many of developers write content? Very few. Very few. Scared of content, right? So that's why, how many of those developers look at the structure of the content, saying, you know, I am developing, I want to see how the structure looks like. How many of them look at the structure? Okay, few people look at the structure. So how many of the developers, you know, here, when installing plugins, do you try too many plugins? Like, you know, building a website, how many of them make a website? Not a product, but a website. Okay, a lot of them make websites. So do you often try looking at installing different plugins and themes? You keep trying different plugins, different themes. So you'll know from this, you know, what happens to the blog, to the customer, when we keep doing that. Okay, so we'll be going through the checklist to keep your blog healthy for search engine rankings. So the health of the blog starts from day one, when the developer sets up a website for the customer. Okay, so you try different plugins, themes, and stuff, and then you migrate to the live production site. Okay, so we'll go through that so that, you know, the content writers know that what happens behind the scenes as well. Okay, so I tried finding a lot of GIFs. All of them are copyrighted. So thanks to MediaWiki and WikiCommons that I could find images which is open source and appropriate for the slides. So a lot of them say, you know, content is the king, right? But don't forget who controls it. We all know, okay, yeah, I've written a content. How do I get it on top? We all know who controls it, right? So it's pretty important to know what should we do continuously on the blog to make sense so that the controller keeps you relevant. Okay, so first thing is, we need to know the structure of the content. What is important in the structure? The number one, most important, is the title. Usually you have keywords at the beginning of the title, so that, you know, if people are searching for it, they come to know about it. But before that, number one point, remember, it's for your reader. It's for your reader, because you want traffic to come, but if they don't act on it, they don't like it, it doesn't matter, right? You will be spending more money on maintaining the site and traffic rather than getting anything out of it. So number one, it's for the visitor. So title is important, the structure of the title. So when you develop websites, do ensure that you check that the structure is correct. So day one, title structure has to be correct. Next one is the meta description. Why meta description? Because the person who is searching on Google sees a small snippet there, which makes them feel, oh, I want to click on it, right? So that has to be something where, you know, the visitor says, I want to click on this because it looks interesting. Okay, not for the search engine, remember that. It's for your user. The next one, the header tags, H1, H2, H3. The document text, as we all know. The images, a lot of them forget about the images. So structure of the image, like, you know, the alt text, the file name that you use on the image, those things also matter. And any bold text that you use. These are just the minimal parts of it. So these things, as a developer and as an end user, that you should remember that the structure has to be correct. But also remember, don't forget the search engine. Okay, you're writing for the user, but unless we are so dependent on, you know, who brings the content in front of our users, that we have to take care that we have a correct structure so the search engine understands what the site is about and serve it to the user who is looking for that content. Okay, so how do you, how many of you have blogs which have run for, you know, more than a year? You have a lot of blogs. What kind of issues do you face, you know? Initially, when you set up the blog, it's pretty fast, right? And beyond a time, you see, oh, what's happening? It's not running that fast. How many of them see that problem? You have visitors, you see that, right? Over a period of time, it happens. How many of you remove content regularly? Very few. Very few, right? We keep on writing content, but how many of you remove content? Not many. So what happens, right? You have to prune regularly, because that's important for the health of your blog. It's like, you know, you shed your weight to remain fit. Same thing with your blog. It has to shed some weight. So what has to be removed? You need to go to your GA, Google Analytics, go to behavior, site content, all pages. Look at the visits that your sites are, the pages are having. And if there's not enough traffic, look at it, you know, is that content relevant? Should you remove it or do you need to refresh it? So it's as important as writing a content. This is the another critical phase or critical part of the website that many bloggers don't look at. Okay, refreshing content, right? It's all about content nowadays. You all, how many of you look at streaming content? Yeah, all those, you know, the new age streaming content, over the top content, all of them, most of them look at it, right? Why do you look at that? You get fresh content every time. You like it. Same with the search engine. Same with your users. They like fresh content. It doesn't mean new content, but whatever content is there on your blog, love it, right? Keep on refreshing it so that it is new and relevant to the users. So you shouldn't have a case, you know, where you see here the carpenter and the walrus, where you are looking for, you know, 6 months you are spending cleaning it up. You have to do it regularly. The next one, when you start, you know, someone says, oh, Gutenberg is the fresh new thing. Let's write content. So every week you're writing content. Oh, Gutenberg is this. Next week, Gutenberg is this. Again, Gutenberg is this. Doesn't help, right? You look at your content and see whether there's an existing article. So you will go to Google, say site colon your site domain, and in title your keyword. Okay, look for any content which is already there for that particular keyword. If you write more content, it's not that there's a penalty, but usually what happens is, you see, right, Google has omitted some pages from the result. They do it. Okay, they say, you know, this looks like duplicate, so it just hides it off. So it doesn't help you when you have such content which is there on your site. Again, I came back to it. You have to refresh the article. Like, you know, Jitesh covered it, the corner store articles. As you write more articles around your main pillar articles, go back, maintain your health of your blog to refresh back those links. Or update your corner articles, because that's critical for your website. Okay, so it shouldn't happen like, you know, the Alice in Wonderland. She keeps looking at both the twins. Next one, this is very critical. Okay, the performance of your blog and your site is absolutely critical. So if it is slow, even if you have great content, it's unlikely you would rank on top. Because the search engine is not serving you, it's serving the end user. The user would be happy if whatever they are searching for and whatever they are reading appears faster. Here, it's pretty important to know, how do you check it? You go to GA, Google Analytics, and it has the link to look at your page timings. So look for your pages which are important, the posts which are important. What are the timings on that? Is it degrading month on month, week on week, day on day? And look at it. Why is it degrading? A lot of people don't know. Plugins. How many of you have trackers to to look at, you know, which plugins are installed, why they are installed, who installed it, are there any duplicate plugins doing the same stuff? You know, there are multiple plugins with content forms. Do you have keep on adding it? Remember, okay, clean it up. Don't keep too many plugins. Just keep the bare minimum necessary. Why? Because every time the page loads, all these, because you know WordPress is event driven, all of them get triggered one after the other. It just runs and it slows down the site. A lot of people don't look at this WP options. Bloggers, do you look at the database? Any blogger who looks at the database? Right. So look at WP options table. Okay, there is a column called as auto loaded, which says yes. By default, any settings that a plugin or a theme adds on your site, it goes in here with the default value of yes. Okay, so this loads every time the page is loaded. It's in memory and it consumes your RAM. So as you add and keep on changing your plugins, it builds up. So you say, oh, the site is the same. I have just written more content. Why do I need to upgrade my server? Why do I need to upgrade my CPU, RAM? That's where it goes. How many plugin developers here during uninstall of the plugin look at WP options? Very few. Please, WordPress is a community which has helped us. We need to take care of our users. It's very important that we have a site which doesn't degrade over time because we don't clean up the WP options. A lot of plugins remove the tables, but they don't take care of the settings. So if you can, you know, prompt them when they are uninstalling, is it a temporary in nature or is it permanent? Would you want to clean up the settings? If it is yes, help the users clean it up. For the people who are not looking at databases, the customers, the users, if you already have a site which is running slow, go into WP options and search for the plugin name which you have already uninstalled. And if you find settings about that plugin, you can remove it. Or take a help from a developer to help you out. Consider a CDN. This is pretty important over time as you have a blog. Because if you don't spend on a CDN and if you want to have a high performance, you would have to boost your server, which is more expensive. Right? It feels that, you know, CDN looks more expensive, but not really. Your existing server, if you want to hit that kind of scale, you have to spend a lot. CDN helps. Okay, what is CDN? Because you have your images. Most of the content that you have on your site will be images, will be the JavaScripts, the CSS, all these things you don't want to serve from your server. It has to go from somewhere else because that's not needed on the WordPress PHP area, right? So definitely consider a CDN if you want to get good performance of your site for your end user. Review the structure. You have to continuously review the structure. You know, over a time, you look at this, you look at the site and say, oh, I've never seen my site is looking so strange after 3 years. What are so many links here, you know, on the right, in the sidebar, at the footer, everywhere? Look at it. The structure of the site matters, whether you want to keep it flat or hierarchical. So the more the number of clicks the user has to come to your content, the less likely is the search engine saying, you know, this looks relevant or important for the user. The structure matters. The cornerstone or the pillar articles, right? How quickly can they reach there? Is it there on the homepage? Is there a link on the homepage? Is it easily accessible? The links on your site, the interlinks, pretty important. We run behind backlinks, right? But interlinking is pretty important because that's where you show to the search engine, oh, this article is important for me. All my article links are coming there. That's also important. Broken links. If the sites have, you know, broken images, broken links, user doesn't get a good experience on it. It also slows down the site when it loads. It goes 404 again, brings back the 404 outcome. That takes time. Sitemap XML, do keep looking whether the sitemap gets regularly updated as you post content, as you remove content. The robots, S is missing, robots.txt, right? This is a text which shows to the search engine what areas to look for on your site and not go, you know, all over the place. And the page structure. There are a lot of audit tools available. Keep on auditing continuously to see the structure is correct so that your health of your blog is optimal. Thank you. My session was just before lunch, so this may not be relevant right now unless you all are already hungry. Any questions?